Hello and welcome. After testing your Zurn Wilkins 350AST, are you noticing some issues? No worries. We'll go through some troubleshooting and maintenance steps to get your valve functioning properly. Remember, only certified personnel should perform maintenance on backflow preventers. Faulty maintenance could result in an improperly functioning assembly. Testing should be done at least once a year or more, as specified by your local plumbing codes. When it comes to backflow preventers, two of the most common problems we hear about are leaking check valves and low or no water flow. In this video, we'll talk about the potential causes of each and the recommended corrective actions. First, let's gather some of the tools you'll need. Leaking check valves. If you notice a leaking check valve during testing, here are some possible explanations. Debris on the seat or seal ring, a damaged seat edge, a damaged check O-ring, or a damaged bolt O-ring on the check retainer. Any of these issues could result in the valves failing to seal, causing a leak. Let's begin by taking the valve out of service and removing the check valves. Start by closing the inlet and outlet shutoff valves. Open the number 2, 3, and 4 test cocks to release pressure from the valve. Leave them open during check valve removal and reinstallation. Loosen and remove the grooved coupling around the access cover. Then, remove the cover. Drain the remaining water from the assembly by loosening or removing the brass flanged cover plate on the bottom center of the valve body. Make sure the O-ring does not wash away as the valve drains. Remove the number one check assembly by unscrewing the four nuts and washers securing the number one check valve assembly to the body. Then remove the check valve from the body. Next, we'll remove the number 2 check valve assembly. Unscrew the 7 nuts and washers and remove the retaining ring. Then, remove the number 2 check valve from the valve body. Pro tip: service only one check valve at a time to avoid mixing parts. Secure the check valve and remove the 6 bolts, washers, and O-rings from the back of the check assembly. Separate the seal retainer from the assembly to expose the seal ring. Inspect the seal ring for cuts or embedded debris. If the reverse side of the seal is unused, the seal can be flipped and used temporarily until a new seal is obtained. Inspect the seat edge by running your fingernail around the edge and feeling for nicks or other damage. Inspect the check O-ring and replace it if cut, pinched, or damaged in any way. You can lubricate the O-ring to hold it in place in the groove. It's important to note that if any portion of the check assembly is damaged or missing, or if the seat sealing edge is damaged in any way, do not attempt to field repair it. Contact a Zurn customer care representative for assistance. Inspect the O-rings on the retainer bolts for cuts. Replace if necessary. Now we can reassemble the check valve by performing the previous actions in reverse, stopping after tightening the bolts, washers, and O-rings on the back of the check valve. Repeat the previous maintenance steps on the number 2 check assembly. Using your finger, inspect the valve seating area. Flush with water to remove any debris. Note any rust or damage. Before reassembling the unit, refer to the maintenance instructions on Zurn.com. Now we can reinstall the number 2 check valve. The number 2 check valve must be installed in the orientation shown here. Place the number 2 check valve in the body and hold it against the sealing surface while sliding the retainer over the 7 studs. Continue holding the check against the sealing surface and install the washers and nuts finger tight. Then evenly torque the nuts to 15 foot-pounds. Install the number 1 check valve and hold it against the sealing surface. Continue holding the check against the sealing surface and install the washers and nuts finger tight. Evenly torque the nuts to 15 foot-pounds. Reassemble the access cover and grooved coupling. Make sure the ends of the coupling touch each other when fully bolted. Close the three open test cocks. If the bolts on the cover plate on the bottom of the valve were loosened to drain the valve body, retighten them now. Be sure the O-ring is still in its groove. Now you can place the valve back in service. Now that the unit has been repaired, test the unit for proper operation. Please refer to the testing procedures document on Zurn.com for details. If you're experiencing low or no water flow, here are a few potential causes. The assembly was installed backwards. The gate valves are not fully open. Or there could be a low supply pressure. Begin by verifying the valve was installed correctly. Check the flow direction by locating the arrows on the valve body. Water should flow in the direction of the arrow, from inlet to outlet. Verify that the gate valve handles are fully open by turning the handles counterclockwise until they stop rotating. If you're still experiencing a low flow rate, attach a pressure gauge to test cock number 1 and verify that you have sufficient supply pressure to open the check valves. Zurn recommends a minimum of 20 PSI for proper operation of the double check valve assembly. If you're still experiencing issues, please contact Zurn Customer Care for more information. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting and maintenance video for the Zurn Wilkins 350AST Double Check Valve Assembly Backflow Preventer. And make sure to visit Zurn's YouTube channel for many more helpful installation and troubleshooting videos.